टैली एक्सरसाइज नंबर वन, एंटर द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजैक्शन इन टैली एंड डिस्प्ले द कैश बुक। हियर अप्रैल 2020 मंथ डिटेल्स आर गिवन। ओपनिंग कैश लेजर, ओपनिंग बैलेंस ऑफ कैश इन हैंड इज 1500 एंड देर आर टोटल 6 एंट्रीज। परचेज गुड्स फॉर कैश ₹320, सोल्ड गुड्स फॉर ₹480 फॉर कैश, रिसीव्ड कमीशन ₹65, पेड कमीशन ₹55, पेड टू राम ऑन अकाउंट ₹715, पेड टू सैलरी टू द ऑफिस क्लर्क ₹100 एंड ऑफिस रेंट ₹60। सो आफ्टर पोस्टिंग द एंट्रीज आवर कैश बुक कैश बैलेंस विल बी 795। नाउ फॉर दिस आई विल क्रिएट वन कंपनी, क्रिएट अ कंपनी फ्रॉम द कंपनी इन्फो। सो हियर आई विल टाइप द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी, बैच 2021। सो आई विल टाइप द मेलिंग एड्रेस एज इट इज हियर, बैच 2021। यू प्रोवाइड ऑल द डिटेल्स ऑफ योर कंपनी। हियर आई विल स्टेट सेलेक्ट एज अ कर्नाटका, पिन कोड, टेलीफोन नंबर। सो रेस्ट ऑफ ऑल डिटेल्स here I'll select the type of the company as account only, and financial year begins with 1/4/2021. Press Ctrl plus A to save the company. Okay, so here from the gateway of Tally, so right now it shows here batch 2021 and there are no vouchers entered so far. So from the master's account info, we'll create the accounts ledgers. So here it from the accounts info, groups and ledgers are here. So click on the ledgers and click on create. Before that, I want to show you the predefined ledgers which are comes with the Tally package after once the company is created. So here see, we will find two ledgers which are predefined by the Tally package once the company is created, that is cash and profit and loss account. So in our problem, opening balance, that is opening balance 1500 is given. So we'll alter the opening balance 1500 here. For this, so I'll create a ledger from alter. So I'll provide the opening balance cash in hand. Okay, so that is opening balance 1500 in account. Press Ctrl plus A or press yes here. Now right now there are only two ledgers and the opening cash balance 1500 is recorded. Now we'll move to create the rest of ledgers according to what we require. For example, here purchase goods for cash, sold goods 480 for cash, received commission, paid to Raman account, paid to salary to the office clerk. So we will create one by one ledgers. So for this, first we click on the ledgers, create. So for the create, we'll create the ledger of purchase sales and commission, purchase account. Purchase account. So here see the list of the groups that comes automatically by the Tally package. So we need to select purchase accounts comes under purchase group. So I'll select purchase group. Right now I will not provide any details of purchase ledger, name, address, state and this. So and here opening balance also I am not providing. Simply just press Ctrl plus A. So second ledger for us is sold goods for ₹480 for cash. So again for second, sales comes under sales account. Just to select the sales from the list or select from here and press Ctrl plus A to save the ledger. Next ledger is received commission ₹65. So received commission, UMMISS, a commission received. Commission received is the income, and again from the income it is indirect income. Ctrl plus A. Next transaction is paid commission. Paid commission commission paid. So it is the type of expense, indirect expense. Control plus A. Next entry, paid to Ram on account. So paid Ram is paid means it is an expense. So here Ram is a personal account, sundry debtor. Ram account, sundry. Here it shows the two types of personal accounts, sundry creditors and sundry debtors. So in this case, our transaction is paid to Ram on account. So Ram will become sundry debtor. So here it asks the maintain bill by bill details. So right now it is not required for us. So I'll press no and press Control plus A. Next transaction in our in the month of April 2020, paid salary to the office clerk and office rent. So office paid salary account is the expense. Again from the expense, it is an indirect expense. Control plus A. And office rent again it is indirect expense, and press Control plus A. Now press escape from the keyboard and back to the main menu of masters. From the accounts info, now we'll see the ledgers what we created. Click on the display. So here see, now the ledgers here we have created all the ledgers. Cash it is a default that comes in, and there we have updated our opening balance, commission paid, commission received, office rent, profit and loss account, purchase account, RAM account, salary account and sales account. So now I'll record this all the transactions one by one. How to record this transaction? To record this transaction, we need to back to the gateway of Tally menu. From the transactions, here we select the accounting vouchers. From the accounting vouchers, so here it comes as a debit and credit. So it is only the one option. So click on F11. And press single mode option no. From the F12, press no and press Control plus A. So now it shows you debit and credit item. Okay, for now purchase goods for cash rupees 320. So purchase means it is an expense for us. Our income is goes out, so and goods are comes in. So purchase account debit to cash account. So here in Tally we have purchase account, sales account, all these vouchers are appear on the right side vertical bar. So we need to select from the accounting vouchers. When you select the outing vouchers, default it shows as a payment voucher. So here for this I'll select as a purchase, but it is a cash transaction. Cash transaction means it is purchase goods for cash rupees 320. So I'll select purchase, and here it asks you to supplier invoice number. I'll type as supplier invoice number and date as it is. And now here I'll select as a cash. It shows you two accounts, you so purchase account debit to cash account. I'll select as a cash. So amount is 320, purchase goods for cash 320. So I'll type as a 320 here, and purchase account 320 being goods purchase for cash. Press Control plus A. Okay, to save the entry. Now second entry, sold goods for 480 for cash. For this we have your sales voucher. Second entry, press F2 if you want to change the date. Press F2 voucher date, and press F8. So here again it shows as a rate per amount. So we required as a voucher, press Control P as a voucher to appear your voucher in a debit and credit. So earlier it appeared as an invoice. So in invoice you can supply the details about the particulars, rate per amount, if the goods details are given. Right now here invoice details are not provided in the question. So I'll take as a voucher. Okay, so here reference number you type. So again it is a cash account. So entry is sold goods for rupees 480 for cash. So cash account debit to sales account. So similarly here, see here it prompt by, so cash 480 and sales account 2. See, in a sales account it asks you credit debit item first, and later it asks you credit item first. So cash account 480, cash account debit, and sales account debit. So in a particular, this way we can record the transaction, and we type the narration here being cash sales. Press Ctrl plus A. Next transaction is received commission rupees 65. So amount comes in. So it is a receipt. So we press as a F6 receipt. Cash comes into your business. So if it is F6, so how here we have this received commission. So it prompts you two item, credit item first in receipt voucher in tally. So here we record the credit item first. So tally prompts you to the user to record the credit item. So as per the practice, we are recording the debit and credit, but in tally, as per the nature of transaction, how it is occurred, and that is prompted here. So it asks you to record the credit item first. So credit item, so here 2, received commission rupees 65. So here 65 and cash 65 being commission received. Yes, yes. Next again press F2, date. Next transaction for us here, paid commission 55. So paid means it is a payment, commission paid, amount is 55. So 55 cash, 55. Commission account debit to cash account being commission paid. Next transaction is paid to Ram on account 715. Paid again, press F, payment voucher here, paid to Ram account, select Ram account from the list, 715 to cash account being cash paid to Ram account. In cash paid to Ram, press Ctrl plus A. Last transaction for us here is paid to salary to the office clerk 100 and office rent. It is a compound entry, it is a payment entry. Paid to office clerk 100, paid to office salary account, salary 100. Now here you just press B by and office rent from the list. Office rent is, the transaction is 60, so total is 60 and cash being salary and office rent paid. See here, now our cash balance, it shows 795. As per our exercise, there also cash balance is 795. Now it is tallied, our cash balance 795. Press Ctrl plus A. So press Escape key and back to the gateway of tally. To view the reports, click on a display and click on account books, select cash and bank book. So our cash in hand is 795.